Hello, today we're going to paint a sunflower. First, we're going to use the plateau blue for our sky. Let's try to paint our sky. And we can mix with the turquoise. A little bit of titanium white. And we can come back later after it is dry. But for now, that's our sky in there. And I'm going to create like a horizon. This is gonna be in a field, so lighter part in the horizon. Let's do the titanium white like that. We can use the raw umber. I'm going to make a tiny mountains like that in a distance, and kind of mix with a little bit of blue and green. Do another raw umber somewhere here. That, and then we can make another one here on this side. We don't really want a tall, it's like a hill, it's just a small hill. Another raw umber. There you go. There you go. That would be our mountain in the far. Then in our field, we can mix titanium white mix with roshana. Kind of like that. That's our field. More white. The closer to the mountain are like lighter. And then the green for the grass. It's like a field. If you notice, we did kind of similar technique in the bunny painting, step-by-step bunny painting. If you've never seen it yet, go and watch it. And the light green, we can do light green mixed with yellow and then chana, more white like that. More white, a little bit more chana, and more white. We're going to have a flower field, so we're gonna do like that. Then I'm gonna use the raw umber. The more I get closer. This part here, I get darker, so I'll just keep adding, and you can use a little bit of plateau blue to is kind of green. Like that. And then more white just to kind of blend it. Raw umber. Like that. More raw umber. So there you go. Can add a little bit of green in there. Just a field. So there you go. And that's our field. We have our sky, we have our mountain in the back. Then we can do really white in here for the horizon, kinda. Okay. And change that again later when it's dry to kind of emphasize the horizon. Then we can use our slanted brush. Do your plateau green. Let's add a tree, tiny tree. Like that. It's like a distant tree. Alright, and then I'm going to use, I think it's still wet, I'll try the lighter green to kind of highlight the other part of it. It's still wet, so it doesn't really show. Then just use the raw umber for kind of like the shadow in the bottom. Just like that. Then we can use our, you can use the fine brush or the rectangle brush. So if it's still wet to work on and you can't wait, you can blow dry it. We'll try to blow dry it and we'll see. I don't think we can work on it yet, so we'll try to blow dry. good. I just blow dry it and it's good to go now, so we can continue our painting. I'm going to highlight the two trees in the back. So I'm going to use light green and yellow. Just this tip part. This one in here, I'm just going to highlight that part in there. Just like that. And in here as well. So I'm going to do the same with the other one. And I'll add white to really highlight more some part of it. Give you some depth. Alright. And a little bit darker in the bottom. So we have two trees. You can add as many trees do you want. So there's no limitation to the trees you like to add. Then I'm going to kind of smart. It's like not to push. It's just like a very, very gentle touch. And then smudge it like this. Add a little bit of white. I don't really want a lot. Just kind of like a hint of green in there. So, just like that. This is my grasses in a far distance. There you go. So we don't really want a lot. Just bit. It might sound that I'm really pushing my brush to the canvas, but no, I'm just kind of like tapping it really, really slow. So that's my glasses, and I will use the fun brush. Where's my fun brush? I really need to buy me a fun brush. Here you go, I found you. Alright, I'm gonna use this fun brush for wildflowers in there in my field. So I'm gonna this one is the portrait pink. So I'll just randomly dab that everywhere. So just kind of like tap it, not too hard, random. This is the random wild grass flowers. This is a field, just a random tap. So, went to Texas one time and they have beautiful flowers in there. Wildflowers, so trying to kind of mimic it. No, it's not going to be the same. Let's add also a rosa, a rose color. So, a little bit of rosa. And just tap it, dab. It's not too much. You can add it. This is the same technique I use on the bunny that I did. You've seen that. It's kind of the same for my field. And then, of course, We are going to use yellow. I'm gonna use the darker yellow, not the cadmium light yellow. I'm going to use the cadmium yellow medium. So just kind of tap to add colors in our field. There you go. Let's add colors a little bit. So, I'm not sure if you see it. Let's zoom in. Oh, that's how it looks like. Okay. Then we can add our red. I want to use the lighter red. This is cadmium light red. So just dub here and there. Oops, that's too much. It's okay. Maybe some part of it, some areas are a lot of red. Okay. And then let's grab darker green, your flood of green mixed with the light green, kind of random, because some of our area are might be darker shown in the light, you know, in the sun. Add a little bit of shana like that. So just keep adding white to lighten the color, because it's a little bit too much. I don't want a lot. So just do that. I'm adding white a little bit. Our sunflower should be here. I'm just kind of adding a little bit of detail in our sunflower. Okay. So I'm try to go green for our grasses. There you go. Just kind of random, some of it are patches. So I don't really want all green. Just patches of green. There you go. Then I'm going to add more of the shana. Somewhere like that, because some of it are like no grass looking area. There we go. Some white. All right, so this area in here I'm gonna probably leave it for now. So let's try to do our sunflower pattern. So let's use the burnt umber for the center of our sunflower. So I'm gonna make a big sunflower, so, like a partial of it. Just a partial bit, just a bigger brush. Probably could use this one too. So. Okay, that's kind of the center of the flower. Partial of the center of the flower. Or we can eat those sunflower seeds. Okay, like that. Then I'm going to use the I probably could use the burnt sienna. Let's try burnt sienna. Okay. Oh, just kind of in the tip of your brush. Not much. So we can do kind of oblongish part of it, like so. What kind of shape do you call that? Just like that. So that's kind of our pattern for our sunflower. Let's see if you can see it. There you go. This part in here is just that part. On the top, maybe one part. There you go. There's a huge sunflower. And then we'll use the darker yellow, medium, because I got both. I got the yellow light and I got a yellow medium. So next would be the yellow medium. Okay, same way, just in the top. Then let's kind of do that part. There you go, just like that. See, we're gonna layer this, so you can't really just color it up one time. Oh, but probably could, but I prefer not to do that. Well, let's do this way, right? There you go. Then we're going to use the lighter version of the yellow light. This in the tip of your brush. Do it in the middle. You don't need to wash your brush. It's okay to blend them anyways. It's okay. That way. There you go. I like the yellow light because it's very bright. Alright, so that's just the first layer of our leaves. Not leaves, because sunflower are layer. Next one, we're gonna put one in here. That way. See? And then this way. And this way, and of course this one in here, that way. Right, so we're going to use again same routine. Let's start with darker yellow. It's okay if they blend together, that's fine. We want them to blend anyways, like that. Darker yellow, medium yellow, that's what it's called, medium yellow. Finish all with medium yellow, and then in the middle, the light yellow, blend them, there you go, blend them, and blend them. And this one as well. Isn't that pretty? Very bright. Very bright. One of my Patreon, she loves sunflower. And I don't think I have available sunflower to sell. So I'm trying to make one. Maybe she will like this one. Okay. So done with that layer. Now we're going to do the next layer. It's going to be layered. Alright. So you see this in here? This area? So we're going to add in there. So this area as well. This area, that area, this area. So we're gonna add, just keep adding. So for here, so let's do this part. See? And this part. You know, this is getting thinner. And that part, this part, this one, yeah. Then let's use the darker yellow, medium yellow. Medium yellow. Medium yellow. I think there's a sunflower that is burgundy color. You can use that too if you prefer that color sunflower. This is a very easy step-by-step how to make sunflower for beginners. So, medium yellow. And then this one in here. Medium yellow. There you go. We're gonna let it dry for now. We're gonna create, oops, I forgot that part. Gonna let it dry, then we might be able to layer another layer in there. We'll see. In here we can use the black, marsh black, and I'm using the round tip brush, and then just kind of dab it, you know, those seeds. The seeds are kind of like that. So just dab it all over in this part. There you go. A hint of white, kind of emphasize. Like highlight of it, the one that got hit with the shine of the light. very simple, very easy. You can try it yourself. There you go. We can go back with that later. So let me zoom in how it looks like. Maybe I can just drag it. There you go. So that's our sunflower. Let's try to. Add, I think it's still wet, so we can't add quite yet. So we can add one in here if you want. You can add one in here. I would like to try another one layer before I want to add another sunflower in one of either side. There you go. So we're going to use the lighter white, lighter yellow, I mean, with mixed with white. So I'm going to create another one in here. Too much. I'm painting, Lay. Almost done. Okay, so here is our sunflowers. I decided to add another one. So that's it. It's very simple sunflower. We can add a cloud in there. So I like to add clouds in my sky. I don't like it plain. It looks sad when it's clear sky. Well, sometimes clear sky is pretty. I just like to add clouds. For some reason, I like clouds. There you go. That's better, I think. Alright, I'm gonna finish this now because we are about to eat our dinner. There you go. Thank you for watching, and I hope you like my simple step-by-step sunflower.